So before I start this video, I just want to give it a couple shout-outs. The couple shout-outs I want to make is the Kablammer, because I really want to see him make that Q&A. So go to his channel, I guess. Dubba King, because I recently edited his, re-edited, I mean, his video on Marcus Indoors, which is where he plays a terrible game and tries to tolerate it. That will be in the link in the description below, and a card will appear right on the screen right now. Go check that out, because I'm really proud of that, and it was like 6 minutes before, and now it's like 3. That's how short I cut down videos. Also, I'm really proud of that video, so I really wish you guys can check it out. There's Nuka Quartz, because he really needs help, because the YouTube purge just like took away subscribers. And yeah, just go subscribe to this. Go subscribe to him, not this. He's a person. I don't know why I feel the need to give shout-outs in my videos, because I really want my friends to, you know, get more of an audience so then they can continue making the content. Also, Burnt Lime, because she can't make videos for, like, a week now because technical difficulties, I mean. Go subscribe to her either way. And the last thing I want to talk about in the beginning of this video is cry for help for my brother. So recently my brother's been, you know, he doesn't have access to Pokemon Go anymore. He used to. We actually recorded a video of me and him catching some Pokemon Go. His perspective wasn't recorded though, so it was only mine. He was able to play the game on his phone. But now that he's like factory reset, so like when he factory reset his phone, he wasn't able to play Pokemon Go anymore because it said this device isn't compatible with this. It's really odd how he was able to play before, but now he's not able to. It's really weird, and I hope we could reach out to the company who made this game and, you know, hopefully fix this thing. Anyway, let's get to the point of this video. The point of this video is going to be an analysis on the Steven Universe Summer of Steven promo. I've wanted to do this like last, as soon as it got, you know, like shown, but I was too late on that. I also had this other big project to work on, which was the late 3 anniversary video, and that took a long time to make. Or like, I just got lazy, it just took me like 3 days or something. 3 years, 3 days. I don't know, I think I've worked on it for like 3 days. And because Cute Cut Pro doesn't wish to function. please give me a free code for the Cute Cut Pro full version. I don't want to use this anymore. Speaking of that, I got Adobe Premiere finally. Again. Because I wanted to see how it changed. And it's actually working. Sort of. Back to the top of the video again, because I keep rambling. So the new Steven Universe promo came out like weeks ago. And I wanted to do an analysis on it. I don't know if my friends will do it. Dubba King won't do an analysis because all of his other ones just like were bad to him. I personally liked it anyway. But yeah, we're gonna get on this analysis. First thing you see in the promo is Steven and his dad just like running out. And then you see in a clip of Steven Floats, surprisingly, from the leak. I think it was France that premiered it like early, like really early. But it's now confirmed Steven Floats will be premiering in Summer of Steven. And then you see a boat, which is with Steven and Lapis having a lot of fun. I'm really curious to see why this is happening and how this happened. Seeing how Lapis hates the ocean now, I don't know why she's hanging around the ocean. And it shows Amethyst, Peridot, and Steven. Peridot with a tablet on her arm. I really want to know what happened with that. There's also another promo. I like this other thing. Not promo, it was this other thing on the Cartoon Network Anything app. Then you see Steven with rocket sandals. Go ask your boy on your flight into space. Like, what? See, Lapis laughing for some reason. And then we see my favorite, Stevani. You see her with freaking, like, just being looking all sassy and shit. And then you see Peridot just suddenly surprised, and then see Steven sliding down a water slide, which is confirmed to Mr. Greg. Judging from the short clip we got, it looks really good. I really am excited. And we see Connie and Steven together. I'm guessing this is the episode where Stevani debuts again, because she has the same jacket as Stevani. And you see Steven just like bouncing Amethyst as a ball and hitting Peridot in the face. And see Steven and Amethyst together. I don't know what's gonna happen. I think this is the same episode with Steven, Amethyst, and Peridot. And this clip looks like season one animation, because Pearl's facial expressions just remind me of Cheeseburger Backpack for some reason. I don't know what's going to happen here. And also, Mr. Greg, Pearl in a suit. A freaking salt shaker with a suit. Wearing a suit, I mean. And then you see another clip of Mr. Greg, and then this clip, I have no idea. And then it just shows the date, which is going to be Monday, July 18th, weeknights at 7 p.m. Oh, I'm excited. This is like a Steven Nuke, basically. And that's where the promo ends. Oh my, I have a lot to say about this. First of all, Mr. Greg seems like an episode that will be, I think it will be a filler, or probably will, you know, see more about Pearl, I don't know. It looks like she's hiding something, and we're going to learn about that in the episode. The Stefani one, I have no idea why she looks mad. No idea why they're fused in the first place. But all I know is that, oh my god. I just found a really great frame. Oh my god, I'm going to share with that now. Steven looks like he has just long arms and that face. And Amethyst's expression says it all when I found this frame. Anyway, that's enough of me fooling around with that. Yeah, we're very close to July 18th. Also, new gem has been revealed. Her name is Bismuth. Bismuth is the one that poofed, who is it called? Lapis. If you didn't see from Same Old World, you see how she, you know, like, just, like, poofed Amethyst. No, Amethyst, am I that stupid? Bismuth was the one that poofed Lapis in, Same Old World. Or at least she looks like it, because, come on, it's a high chance that she is the one. But yeah, Bismuth is an old crystal gem that fought with the crystal gems in the war. And, oh my, I really love her personality. I really love how the way she looks. What I don't like is how it looks like a fake leak. That's what, I thought it was a fake leak. I was like, wait, oh my, the thing just closed. Oh my, I will be mad if whatever it just cuts out, but whatever, we're gonna continue what I'm talking about. Yeah, Bismuth has been shown off, and now we're going to see a new gem. She fought with the crystal gems in the war, and one thing, when I first saw her, she looked like a fake leak, like a fan-made character. But once I watched the video, I saw it, like, it was just amazing. One thing I wanted to fix about her is her hair. Probably make it longer. She actually, she had a moment with Pearl where she was like, both of them started crying. Something. Bismuth looks amazing though, and I love it. Anyways, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. My next video will be about Marcus / Dubba King's dilemma of copyright. I don't care if I spoiled it. I just want you guys to know. So like for now, just subscribe to him. Give him some comments supporting him. I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.